Welcome back, everyone, to Radioland and the Coffee Corner, of course, right?
In our last section, we just learned that Chuck didn't have a very good Friday night at the Comedy Cafe.
And not only that, but Dana didn't have a very good time with her date, Peter, either.
That's right, and we're going to find out more about that right now. Heather is talking to her, and she says, I take it your date wasn't very exciting. So I take it. In other words, from what you're saying, it's my understanding that this date was not very exciting.
And Dana had just shared how she was glad that Chuck was there so that Peter would stop staring at her hair, and it gave her a rest from this one-sided conversation. So from that information, then Heather was able to figure out it must not have been a very good time.
Right, you say figure out. Sometimes we say we interpret somebody's words or their actions, right? Mm-hmm. And we can guess what they're trying to say. So she takes it or understands that from what actually Dana is saying.
And Dana makes it even more clear right here. On a scale of 1 to 10, I'd give it a 0.
Oh.
So both Chuck and Dana rate their evening on a scale of 1 to 10 as a 0.
Well, we know that conversing with Peter was pretty tough. We know that. It was a one-sided conversation. Remember, she says talking with Peter was like talking to a statue or conversing with a statue.
And that's kind of an interesting way she uses this word here, because to actually converse with someone means that you talk with someone. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't seem like Peter was doing much of the talking.
Well, statues don't talk much, and neither did Peter. And so Heather says, well, you can always learn from bad experiences. She's trying to find out something good, and whatever bad experience you have, the good thing is you can learn a lesson from it.
That's right. But it is hard to converse with somebody who doesn't respond to you, and a statue would not, as you said, respond to you. But you're right, that word really does mean it's communication going on between two people, because you can even see in that word converse, it comes from the word conversation. Or maybe conversation comes from this word.
Yeah, but they're both found inside. Well, the one is part of the other word, and you're right. It usually involves two people talking back and forth, and as you mentioned, in a situation like that where no one is talking, it's very awkward, and Heather gives a good piece of advice here that we can learn from this bad or awkward situation.
And Dana has learned. She says, I've learned something very important. I've learned to stay away from Tito's House of Style.
Right. She'll never go back there again. And maybe she's learned some other things, too. Maybe on a first date she needs to do something else with someone new, or avoid situations where you're going to be the only one trying to converse.
Now, you use the word avoid there. She says stay away from, and that's kind of what we're meaning. When we stay away from something, it means that we avoid doing it or avoid going there, usually because we want to stop something bad from happening to us.
Well, we notice Chuck has learned something as well. He says, I've discovered this, or I've learned this. When you try something new and it flops, well, you appreciate the old more. So the idea here, when something flops, is when it fails, right?
Yeah, when something like a performance or a movie or maybe even a book that has all these high expectations and then it fails and doesn't have success, that's what we're talking about when we talk about a flop.
Right, you can be a noun or a verb, can't it?
Mm-hmm. Right. In fact, I think we're going to learn more about that right now.
That expensive new movie flopped.
Why did it flop?
It just wasn't very good.
Did you see it?
No. I don't like to see movies that flop.
So sometimes when we try something new, it might flop or it might be a flop. Chuck found that out, but I don't think that means that we should never take a risk or we should never try new things.
No, I think we should still try new things, but appreciate the old things as well. And that's what he says here. He learned something, that you should also appreciate the old more. So it's great, he says, to be working here with you guys. But do they interpret what he says in the right way?
Well, I think here Patty's saying, hey, wait just a minute. When you say you appreciate the old, are you saying that we are old?
And of course he's not saying that they're old. He's just saying that they're the people he's used to, the friendships he's had in the past, and that he wants to appreciate how good those things are.
That's right. A good lesson. We'll learn more about Radioland next time and all who work there, so we hope you'll join us for that. But right now it's time for us to review our lesson.
Hi, Chuck. So how was your comedy debut?
On a scale of 1 to 10, I'd give it a 0. I had a bad case of stage fright and forgot half my jokes. The only good thing was the size of the audience.
Was there a big crowd?
No, it was tiny.
I don't understand. What's good about a small audience?
What's good is having only a few witnesses to my embarrassment. Unfortunately, Dana was one of them.
If you're talking about Friday night, your performance was the best part.
Really? What did you like most about it?
I like the fact that while Peter was watching you, he wasn't staring at my hair. I also appreciated being able to rest from maintaining a one-sided conversation.
I take it your date wasn't very exciting?
On a scale of 1 to 10, I'd give it a 0. Talking with Peter was like trying to converse with a statue.
I've heard you can always learn from bad experiences, though.
Well, I've learned to stay away from Tito's House of Style.
I've discovered this. When you try something new and it flops, you appreciate the old more. So, it's great to be working here with you guys.
Hey, is he saying we're old?
Hi, 我是 Michelle, 我们开始今天的中文讲解。首先来看这个句子 On a scale of 1 to 10 Scale 本来是指刻度或者是天平在这里是指给分数的单位所以 on a scale of 1 to 10 是指从一分到十分当然一分是最差十分是最好给对方评几分是用 give someone a 后面加上数字例如 if you want me to rate this movie on a scale of 1 to 10I'll give it an 8. 如果你要我从1分到10分给这部电影打分数的话，我给它8分。再来看的是 witness 这个字。witness 在这里是当名词，意思是证人或目击者。见证某件事的证人是用 to 这个介系词。例如 ,there were 5 witnesses to the car accident that took place yesterday. 昨天发生的车祸有5位目击者。Witness 也可以当动词，就是指目击或见证某件意外或事件。例如 ,around 100 people witnessed the plane crash. 大约有100人目睹了坠机的事件。接下来一起看课文的这句话。I take it your date wasn't very exciting. 这边的 take 是指猜想，后面会有 it 开始的子句，说明你所猜想的事情。通常都是对方的言行让你如此猜想。例如 ,You guys already bought the presents. I take it you guys knew about my engagement. 你们连礼物都买好啦。我猜你们已经知道我订婚的事情了。Okay, that's all the time we have for today. See you next time.